The Scepter of Fire, Book 4 in the Oliver Blue and the School for Seers series, written by Morgan Rice, narrated by Harper Reeves. Prologue. Oliver gazed down into Esther's eyes in disbelief. They seemed to be getting greener and greener with every second that passed, as the power of the elixir restored her health.
"You saved me, Oliver," she said, tears glittering in her eyes.
She pulled herself out of his embrace and up to standing. Oliver did the same, staring at her like she was a ghost. Just days ago, she had been at death's door. Now she was standing tall and strong, looking more beautiful and radiant than ever. In fact, she almost appeared to be glowing.
"Esther?" Ralph exclaimed.
"Whoa," Walter murmured.
"You're glowing," Simon stammered, his pale blue eyes as round as moons.
"What is in that thing?"
Hazel exclaimed, looking at the now shattered glass jar in which they transported the elixir. Before Oliver found his tongue, a sudden judder like an earthquake brought him back to the here and now. He suddenly remembered he was back in the School for Seers, and that, for reasons he didn't understand, the whole place was violently shaking and crumbling around them. He glanced down the corridor toward the central atrium. Hundreds of bedraggled Seer students were running around the atrium, injured, covered in debris from the crumbling walls. They were being herded by Dr. Ziblet toward Professor Amethyst. That's when Oliver realised what was happening. Professor Amethyst had activated the hidden time-travelling portal within the kapok tree, and a swirling vortex gaped at its centre. The Seer students were hurrying inside, whooshing away to who knew where. The school was being evacuated.
"That's the last of them," Dr. Ziblet cried,
her white lab coat covered in streaks of dirt.
"The school's empty."
"Then go,"
Professor Amethyst exclaimed. She looked at him, tears shining in her eyes. She gripped his hand tightly.
"Good luck, sir. I hope to see you on the other side."
The old headmaster nodded. Then Dr. Ziblet leaped into the swirling vortex and disappeared. Oliver couldn't quite believe what was happening. He'd known that activating the elixir would have unpredictable results, but never in a million years would he have thought it could cause his beloved school to cave in on itself. The School for Seers was supposed to be indestructible, or at least that's always how he had perceived it. But his meddling in timelines and with the course of history in order to save Esther's life had clearly had a devastating, unexpected impact. He'd saved Esther, but at what cost? Just then, Professor Amethyst spotted them in the corridor.
"Quick," he cried, beckoning to Oliver and his friends from where he stood beside the vortex in the kapok tree.
Oliver looked over his shoulder at his friends hovering behind him, Walter, Simon, Hazel, and Ralph, the best friends a boy could ever hope for.
"The school's falling in on itself," he stammered, disbelief making his throat tighten.
"Not the School for Seers, not his sanctuary."
"We have to evacuate."
"Let's go,"
Hazel said, fighting to stay upright against the force of the shaking. The walls shook and juddered as the gang staggered toward Professor Amethyst. The quaking was so violent it was as difficult as wading through treacle. Inch by inch, the group closed the distance between themselves and their escape to safety. But they were an arm's length from the kapok tree when there came a very loud crack from above. Oliver gasped, his gaze snapping up. One of the kapok's enormous branches had cracked off the tree and was falling. It was coming right for Esther. Without even a nanosecond to think, Oliver dived, shoving Esther out of the way. They slammed to the floor with a painful crunch, Oliver landing hard on top of her. The branch slammed down beside them, bringing debris with it that rained down on them. Esther coughed and peeped out from beneath.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.